A cover or hero section is the first thing visitors see when they land on your website, so it's important to keep it clear, engaging, and product-focused. Today, we will explore how to add and customize a compelling cover for your Tilda website using blocks from the cover category. Let's start by breaking down the key elements of a cover. I will add the CR01 block from Tilda's block library and go to the Content tab. Text is the most important part of the cover since it delivers the first message visitors see. To create a clear website copy hierarchy, structure your cover text with a headline, description, and, if needed, an upper title. Using different background types helps set the right mood and ensures that nothing distracts from the key message. Suppose I want to create a website cover for a whale watching tour company. By default, the block comes with demo text and an image. Let's delete those and start from scratch. In the title field, I will add the main text, Whale Watching Tour. In the description field, I'll specify the expedition dates. In the upper title field, I will mention the company organizing the tour. To hide the editing panel and preview your changes full screen, click the arrow next to the Save and Close button or use the keyboard shortcut. If you don't have a prepared text yet, you can generate the block's copy using Tilda's built-in AI assistant by clicking the star icon in the top right corner. For a detailed guide on using Tilda's AI assistant, check out the Help Center. The link is in the description. Now, let's add some visuals. For the cover's background, you have the option to add an image, apply a solid color, or upload a video. I will upload an image I prepared beforehand. Always choose a background image that complements your text without distracting from it. The optimal image size is 1680 by 900 pixels. After uploading the image, let's save the changes and preview how the cover looks. To replace or edit text, simply click on the text element while editing. If you need to adjust the background settings, use the Block Background Settings widget in the bottom left corner of the block. Here you can change the background to an image, color, or video, edit the image, adjust the filter color and opacity. When working with a color fill background, you can apply linear or radial gradients to add a modern touch to your design. To explore beautiful pre-designed gradient options, check out the Gradients library in the drop-down menu or visit the Tilda Colors page. The link is in the description. For a more dynamic cover, consider using a background video. You can add a YouTube video, a video in MP4 or WebM format. Just paste the video ID or link. To improve loading times and optimize mobile performance, check the option Show Image instead of Video in the mobile version to display an image or GIF as the background on mobile devices. Now let's see how you can customize the look of our cover. Go to the Settings tab to view all the available options. Under the Horizontal Align and Vertical Align settings, you can reposition the text as needed. By default, it is centered both vertically and horizontally. For better readability, I will align the text to the left and set the vertical alignment to bottom. Under the Background Scroll Effect setting, you can adjust how the background moves while scrolling. Hover over each effect to preview how it will appear on a published page. Let's set the scroll effect to parallax, where the background scrolls slower than the foreground content. Now, let's check out the result. Under the height setting, you can set the block's height using either VH, which stands for viewport height, or pixels. If you choose 100VH, the cover will fill 100% of the browser window height, covering the entire screen. Similarly, 1VH equals 1% of the screen height, so 70VH would be 70% of the screen height. If you set the height in pixels, it will stay fixed. For example, setting the height to 600 pixels ensures the cover stays the same no matter the screen size and allows more content to be displayed further down the page. I'll keep the height set to 100VH to ensure the cover always fits the screen, no matter what device or screen size the visitor is using. The next setting is filter color, which, along with opacity, allows you to adjust the image tint to improve text readability on the cover. For example, you can change the filter end color by entering a color code or using the color palette. The opacity setting controls the intensity of the color fill, making it either more opaque or more transparent. Let's set the opacity to 60% for the filter start color and 40% for the filter end color. Now, let's save the changes and check out the result. The next setting allows you to add an arrow at the bottom of the cover, indicating that more content is available further down the page. By default, the arrow is enabled, but you can disable it, change its color, or remove the animation effect. When clicked, the arrow takes the user to the next block on the page. Since I don't need the arrow, I will disable it. Under typography, you can change the text style for the title, description, and the upper title. If these settings aren't specified in the Settings tab, the text will automatically inherit its style from the Fonts and Colors tab in the Site settings. There's a single set of settings for all text elements. Let's break it down in detail, using the title as an example. I'm happy with the text color, but I want to adjust the font size. I'll set it to 82 pixels to make the title more attention-grabbing. Keep in mind that when you set a larger font size, such as 80 pixels, this will only apply to larger screen resolutions. On mobile devices, where the screen is smaller, the font size will automatically revert to the default value for better readability. To set a custom font size for the mobile version, I'll click the screen icon next to the font size field and change it to 24 pixels. This way, different font sizes will be applied for desktop and mobile. I'll keep the font family name as the default. To add custom fonts that are not listed here, go to Site Settings, Fonts and Colors to choose other font options. For a complete guide on working with fonts on Tilda, check out the description. The line spacing is set to 1.55 by default, which feels too wide for me, so I'll reduce it to 1. You can also adjust the line spacing separately for mobile devices by clicking the screen icon. Adjusting letter spacing can be especially useful if you're using capital letters in the title and want to add more space. I'll leave it as it is. The font weight setting allows you to make your text bolder or lighter. I will set it to medium. Below, you can adjust the letter case, such as making all letters uppercase, lowercase, or capitalizing each word. The next setting lets you adjust the top and bottom margins for the text. To bring the upper note closer to the title, I'll set the top margin to 0 pixels. By default, all text elements have a 10-pixel margin. Finally, you can adjust the shadow size and opacity, as well as change the text opacity. I'll leave these settings at their default values. Under background video, you can customize how the video appears on the cover. For instance, you can turn off video looping, disable YouTube's enhanced resizing, and adjust the aspect ratio of the player. I'll keep those settings unchanged. Under animation, you can adjust the text reveal effects for the upper note, title, and description. Let's say I want the text to fade in from the bottom. I'll select this option, preview the animation on the actual page, and then save the changes. Perfect! Everything works exactly as expected. To help search engines index your pages effectively, it's important to set the H1 tag for the most relevant heading, which can be selected under the SEO setting. For other blocks where this setting is present, you can choose H2, H3, or div for the headings. Remember, there should only be one H1 tag per page. If you have separate blocks for the desktop and mobile versions of the cover, ensure the H1 tag is only used in the desktop block. Next, you have the option to adjust the cover border radius by specifying the value for all four corners, or setting different values for each corner. You can also customize the border radius for mobile devices by clicking the screen icon. Under cover padding, you can adjust the padding around the cover. For example, you can create 20 pixels of spacing between the cover and the other blocks. As with the other settings, you can customize the padding separately for mobile devices. The background image position setting lets you adjust the background image's position on the screen. Let's set it to center top. Let's explore the background image position setting with another example to see how it can be helpful. Imagine a background image featuring a dog positioned on the right side. We want to ensure the dog's face stays visible on the right side of the cover without cropping its eyes or nose. Currently, as the screen resolution or browser window size changes, the photo may get cropped if the aspect ratio doesn't match the image proportions. This happens because the system automatically centers the photo across all resolutions. This is where the background image position setting comes in handy, as it ensures the dog's face is visible even when the screen size changes. To keep the dog's face on the right side of the cover, we'll set the background image position to center right. With this setting, the image will always align to the right side, regardless of the screen size or resolution. As a result, the left part of the photo may get cropped, but the dog's face will remain in view, preserving all the important details. Another important element of the cover is the call to action button, and adding one is simple. Just choose a cover block from the library that includes a button like CR17. I've already uploaded an image and added text similar to the previous block. Next, go to the Content tab and add the title for the call to action button. I'll enter Book Now. Then, set an anchor link to hashtag form to redirect users to the form section of your website. For a detailed guide on using anchor links, check out the Help Center. Let's save the changes and preview the result. Now, clicking the button will take visitors directly to the form where they can submit their tour application. Now, let's customize the button style. Go to the Settings tab and select Buttons. This section allows you to add up to 2 buttons with custom settings for each. Since we only need 1 button, I'll set the background color to a linear gradient, then change the text color to white and adjust the border radius to 30 pixels. Additionally, you can fine-tune the button's appearance by clicking Show More Settings. Here you can adjust the drop shadow, select the button font family, set the font weight, change the text letter case, making it uppercase, lowercase, or capitalizing each word. Configure hover effects like text color switch, animation speed, and more. At the bottom of the settings, you can also enable click tracking to send data to web analytics systems like Google Analytics. The button click will then appear in the analytics statistics as a page view. We've covered how to set up a cover with an image, text, and video. For a more detailed guide on working with covers and other Tilda tools, check out the Help Center. The link is in the description. Good luck!